Hi, welcome to General Chemistry with the Professors DuBois. I'm Professor Victoria.
And I'm Professor Corey. We wanted to just give you a little background about ourselves and show you around the classroom a little bit that we're going to be using this semester. So as far as background goes, I was actually a student at SUNY Oneonta. So I graduated SUNY Oneonta with a chemistry degree and went right to work at a pharmaceutical company. It was a really great job. Professor Victoria also got a chemistry degree at a small school in Pennsylvania.
Yep.
And went to work at the same pharmaceutical company that I did. That's where we met each other. And after about 15 years, we wanted to make a change. We wanted to make a better change. So we both actually had to go back to school, and we got a certification to teach high school. So we both went into high school. And had a good run at that, teaching chemistry, physics, all kinds of sciences. And then we ended up, somehow we ended up at SUNY Oneonta, and it's been so spectacular. So
happy to be here.
Let's show them what our Blackboard course looks like.
Okay. So we're going to go over how to navigate the course in Blackboard, which is the learning platform that we're going to be using. Everything you need can be found here. So when you open up our course in Blackboard, you're going to end up at the Start Here page. So it's over here on the left as well. You can always get back to Start Here. And all of these things that are going to help you get started are right here in this welcome message. So make sure that you look at this, go through all of the things that are in here, and follow the directions. Links to important information and whatever else you need are down below it.
So this is MindTap. We have instructions on how to register, and this is our homework system. It's your textbook and your homework system, and it's an online resource. It's quite excellent. The way it's designed, you will have a short reading with a few questions that you have to answer correctly before you can move on. There's multiple attempts. It's no stress. There's tutoring available if you're having some trouble, and we'll help you too. But here's instructions on how to register, and we also made a video that just shows you how to navigate this system. So be sure to watch that.
Watch that all the way through. There's so many questions that we have answered right in that video. And there's a helpful link to get to that site as well. The syllabus is here, and any introductory assignments will be here as well. There are some links at the bottom. We've provided some redundancy in this learning platform, so this frequently asked questions place is where you'd look for the first place that you'd look for some questions. So it's down here at the bottom, but it's also here on the left. So the other places that you are going to be navigating are here on the left. Frequently asked questions is right here.
Let's go to the discussion board. I know it's out of order, but let's just go to the discussion boards. And we've been doing this for quite a while. And where this is really great is before we did this, we would get a lot of email questions, and they'd be the same question over and over, you know, by multiple students, and, you know, realize that this is a very big class. So we created this discussion board so you could post your questions on the discussion board, and then everyone could see the response. And this works great because you can post questions at night. You can answer questions, you know, feel free, and don't be afraid. If you screw it up, we can go in and fix it. We'll make you look good. So don't be afraid to post questions, to respond to questions. And you'll notice we have some categories. Now, that frequently asked questions, that's brand new. That's brand new this semester.
It is. We'll add to it as the semester goes on.
Yeah. So we can, you know, if you have a question regarding lecture, lab, MindTap, we have categories for that. Useful information is so cool. We get a lot of great ideas just based on stuff that students post and useful information. So yeah. If you stumble across something that was really helpful to you, post it up so everyone can see it. I mean, we've learned a lot just from this useful information tab.
So when you have a question, go into the forum, go into lecture, lab, whatever it is, see if the question has already been answered. And if not, post it up and check the syllabus for a bonus. You get a bonus for using the discussion board, so check that out. If we have information that we want to tell you about, we're going to post an announcement so you can get all of your announcements here. There's just really none. Just go to start here to get started is the only announcement right now. But yeah. as we go through, we'll have all kinds of different things that we will send you. It'll be in the announcement, so you'll always have it, but it'll also be emailed to you as well. So check your Oneana email daily for information for us.
Let's check out that Collaborate course room. So this is where you will go to attend the lecture. And when you click on this, you'll see a door up there in the top. That's the course room right there. So you'll just click on that. Want to do it?
Sure.
So they can see what it looks like. There's our join course room. There are some ways you can call in using your phone. There's a lot of different options there, but you'll enter in a place.
It's taking a little time, but
maybe this is a bad idea.
Okay, so joining is me. It is taking a little bit of time. Sure, you can use my microphone.
Yeah, you can. So you'll test your audio here. You'll test your video.
So we would have to fix this, but that's okay. That's where you go in
for the lecture. And what I would recommend is jump in there early. So if you're in the 9 o'clock session, jump in there at 8:45. We'll be in there and we can chat and you can kind of click around and see what capabilities you have. We'll talk more about that once we get started. But certainly check that out and jump in early. We'd like to see you.
Yeah. Any exams and quizzes will be located here. So we'll also have, like I said, we have some redundancy built in. So we would have perhaps at the end of chapter 2, we'll have an exam. We'll have the date in there as well and maybe a link to the exam. But if you're looking for an exam or quiz, you'll always be able to find it there. The chapters are broken out down here. So let's just take a look at chapter 1. You want to talk about some of this?
Sure. So what we've done is we've broken down the first week and we just don't want you to miss anything. So we've tried to make this as clear and easy to follow as possible. So we'll do this for each week and you'll have your checklist. These are the things you have to do. We have embedded the video lectures. So you can watch those. You'll want to watch those in advance of the lecture in Blackboard, because what we're going to do is answer questions and just practice problems. And I think this is going to be really powerful because in the past, we don't get a lot of time to practice problems and that falls on you. Now we're going to be able to do a lot of problems with you. And I think it's really going to be big. So we got some videos. We keep them short. We understand. I mean, watching long videos is extremely boring. We do try to keep them short and entertaining as well.
And we also have them chunked by concept, so that if you're looking for something, if you're like, you want to review subatomic particles and isotopes, you can find that quickly. We have two different types of lectures. We have, or two different types of videos, we have lecture videos, and we also have in-depth, detailed practice on certain concepts. So for example, this one would be, very in-depth information about isotopes. We also have some practice sheets embedded in here as well. So in addition to your homework system with the MindTap, we have created practice sheets for most concepts.
Now these practice sheets are really awesome, because what we've done is we most of these are just one page, and we have the answers, like detailed answers, on the back. So you can work through a problem and then you can check your work. And we try to provide a detailed answer so you can see if you were doing something incorrectly.
Right. Also on here are some links to some help. Open SUNY Help Desk, so that would get you to information technology help. And we also have a link to the Blackboard help pages. So if you're struggling with Blackboard or you're not understanding how to upload a file for an assignment, for example, that can help you.
And they're quite good. The help desk is excellent, and the Blackboard help is very good. All right, we're back.
We're back.
So one of the things I just wanted to say is, you know, we get a lot of students that they really fear this class. It's a hard class. It's very difficult. And
it's challenging.
I think, you know, you're at a real advantage. We have an excellent program and we put so much into this program. And I think some of the things, you know, being high school teachers, we understand what you learned. We understand that it was probably in 11th grade. We understand some of you never even took it.
And that's okay.
And we have many students that have never taken chemistry that just excel. So it's an excellent program. It is a lot of work. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it.
But if you put in the work, you can do this. You can. You can be successful. And we're here to help. And just reach out to us. There's a lot of different ways that we have help built right into the system. And you've already seen some of that already. But we're so excited. We're so excited that we're starting a new term. And we're excited to meet you and work with you. And just know we're here.
All right. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.
Looking forward to seeing y'all.
Yep. Bye-bye.